Lakeview to Bennett. Lakeview to Bennett.
Did you get him?
No dice. I haven't had him for an hour. Lakeview to Bennett.
Daddy.
It's all right, darling. We'll be there soon now.
Lakeview to Bennett. Lakeview to Bennett. Lakeview to Bennett.
Oh, I ain't so worried. Anything Dick Bennett can fly, he can land.
He can't land. We have a ceiling of 300 and a visibility of about 6 inches.
Out in a storm with a sick baby on board.
Well, Dick's that kind of a guy. There ain't another guy who can make it.
He hasn't made it yet.
Oh, he's been in tougher spots than this. You know that. I ain't worried.
Any guy that makes a late parachute jumps like you do hasn't got sense enough to be worried.
Bennett to Lakeview. Bennett to Lakeview. Bennett to Lakeview.
Lakeview to Bennett. Bennett? Go ahead, Bennett.
Coming in.
You can't come in. Ceiling 300, visibility 1/8 of a mile. Go over to Port Dover.
Short of gas. Going to land.
It's like soup down here, Bennett. Keep on the other field.
I'm coming through.
Get out the crash car.
Put this on.
Take care of yourself, honey.
Mr. Bennett, I don't know how to thank you.
Forget it. Good luck to the little girl.
You big phones!
No, you scared us to death.
You better
check up on those motors. They're burning too much gas.
Right.
Say, I got a great idea for that new plane of yours.
Come on, you need some coffee.
Hey, how about some service? What do you got to eat?
Travel down, I'm coming.
We got distinguished company.
Don't tell me it's the great Mr. Bennett.
Hello, Mary.
Hello, what do you have?
Coffee. Me too, and don't forget...
the cream.
Right. Boy, you had me scared to death. From now on, there'll be no more flying till after the Stanley Cup races. We're taking no chances.
Do you really think the plane is ready?
I know it is. Gee, this is what we've been dreaming about for years. You flying the ship that I built.
You've got a lot of money into it, Bill.
Now, don't worry about that. Well, we got freestanding offers for the plans. If we win, we're all set.
How does the competition look?
Well, you got a load of the competition parked in our hangar.
What do you mean?
Oh, a dame barges in with a ship today. I'm telling you, she's got everything on there but a calliope. You know, one of those Miss Millions out looking for a thrill? Why, at the field, they've practically laid out a red plush carpet for her.
Who built the plane?
Oh, I don't know. It's some sort of a foreign thing. You know, the American era slogan, made in America, spent in Europe? Wait till you see it. Well, she's got gold knobs on the controls.
With lace curtains on the windows?
I got $10 that she looks like a ham sandwich. Hey, buddy, pass the sugar. Hey! What was the idea of that?
Compliments from the ham sandwich.
Ham sandwich, eh? I'll take that $10 bet.
Let me have a napkin, Mary.
Oh, what happened?
Nothing. And a fresh cup of coffee.
I said I'd take that bet.
Hey, Carter wants us to go over to the hangar tomorrow and take a look at those two ships he's going to sell to the Russians.
You're not trying to change the subject, are you?
I said Carter wants us to come over the hangar tomorrow and look at those two ships he's going to sell to the Russians.
Okay, we'll go over to the hangar tomorrow and look at those ships.
Looks like you're going over to a hangar and look at some ships.
Dick, what do you think of it?
Carter, she's a pippin. You've got things on there I've never seen in a plane before.
Would you like to fly it?
I sure would.
Why can't you? Can you get out of your contract with Consolidated?
No, have to fly their transports for the next 6 months.
I'll say he does. Frankly, it took the President of the United States to get permission for him to fly our ship in the Stanley Trophy race.
Well, how's it coming?
Fastest thing around. And with this guy in the cockpit, say, we got to get back there.
Yeah. Thanks, Carter, for the offer.
Well, think it over. I'm giving a little informal party night for the boys up in my place. Sort of a send-off before the races. I'll expect you boys up.
Thanks, but...
We'll be there.
So long.
So long, Carter.
So long. Head wind.
Too much fog.
Oh, I got something over here that'll fix that fog.
Well, hello, Major. Glad to see you.
Edwards, I'm glad to see you again.
Major, I'd like you to know Dick Bennett.
How do you do, Major? Pleasure, Mr. Bennett. It's a pleasure, I'm sure.
What do you have?
Oh, a scotch and soda, please.
I don't care for anything, thank you.
Bring me a glass of water, please.
Edwards, I ever tell you...
Yes, Major, you did.
I did. Oh, yes, right. Yes, I did. Well, Bennett hasn't heard it. When I was in the Philippines...
Major, I told Mr. Bennett.
Well, you did. Yeah, that's
right. Oh, thanks. Oh, Carter, show Dick your view from the terrace.
Yes, come along.
Excuse me, Major. You don't know what I got you out of when I got you out of the Philippines.
I can imagine.
Who is that with Bill Edwards?
That's Dick Bennett.
And who may he be?
Don't you read the papers?
Pardon me, boys. I'll be with you in a minute.
Right.
Hey, that's a nice place Carter has here.
Sure is. Nice party, too. Hey, look out, Dick. You'll get dizzy up so high.
You're right. That's too much altitude for me.
Hello, William.
Bill, Leo, how are you? Miss Van Every, meet Dick Bennett.
How do you do, Mr. Bennett?
Dick's on a pilot of my ship in the Stanley Trophy race.
Congratulations. I've been reading about it.
Say, how about a drink? Come on, Dick, let's get
Thanks,
a drink.
Thanks, I'd love it.
You would?
The Baron is going to fly my plane.
Which one?
For the special job.
How do you like it?
Very much indeed.
You're going to have a lot of stiff competition.
Well, I always welcome competition in everything.
Hello, Gail.
Hello, Lyle. I want you to know Baron Hagar.
How do you do, Baron?
How do you do?
Say, I'm in the break. I've got to sing a tune. I hope you'll bear with me.
Hello, Dolly.
Hello, Jean. Miss Van Avery, I want you to know Baron Hagar.
How do you do? Don't miss this Baron. It's good.
Excuse me.
Jack, introduce me to those two men.
Dick?
Yes, Dick. And the other one.
I'd be glad to.
Come on, let's get out of here before they see us.
I don't mind being seen.
But come on, let's get out of here.
You're an old heartbreaker.
Well, never had much success with you.
Dick. Miss Strong, Dick Bennett.
How do you do, Miss Strong?
How do you do?
And this is Bill Edwards.
I didn't quite catch the name.
Strong. My compliments. It was splendid of you bringing that child through the storm last night.
It wasn't anything, just a routine flight. I phoned this morning. The little girl's going to be all right.
I'm awfully glad.
Won't you join us?
Thank you.
May I get you something?
No, not now.
Sit down, Dick. I'm going to mix one.
Miss Strong, Bill, do you think? It's nice out here, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Oh, it's the prettiest penthouse in New York. Oh, that's Lyle's new song. You'll like it.
I don't carry military weapons, but I'm stepping mighty high. Every season, you're the reason I am in love. And in a very military manner, I am marking time, 'cause I know that I'm first in line in the grand old army of lovers who are marching to you. Marking time, 'cause you know that I'm lost in charms when I do the shoulder arms with you in the lover's review. I drill myself on love technique so I can be at ease instead of at attention, 'cause you know, my dear, I aim to please. Marking time, and at my first chance, I'll salute you, because I'm fired with romance. And I've gotta have, and I've gotta have, and I've gotta have you.
you sing?
No, I'm a dancer.
So I suspected.
Lyle, play for me, will you? Me, myself, and I are all in love with you. We all think you're wonderful, we do. Me, myself, and I have just one point of view. We're convinced there's no one else like you. It can't be denied, dear, you brought the sun to us. We'd be satisfied, dear, if you belonged to one of us. So if you pass me by, three hearts will break in two. 'Cause me, myself, and I are all in love with you.
Delightful.
Thank you so much. And you, Mr.
Edwards.
Oh, yes. Did you like it?
I think you sing pretty fair.
Well, it's very generous of you. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
You didn't care for my dancing?
Not particularly.
Is there anything you do care for in particular?
Not particularly.
Would you mind getting me a glass of water?
How long has this been going on?
Second round.
Man, they're practically engaged.
Thank you. I like your friend Dick Bennett.
Oh, you mean old Chatterbox?
He is rather quiet, isn't he?
And he speaks with plainness. And when he talks, he really says something.
Well, you know the old saying, it's better to remain silent and thought a fool than to talk and remove all doubt. Oh, sit down. Just out of curiosity, why do you disapprove of me?
Well, I'll tell you. I don't like people who go to Europe and toss their money around like it was confetti.
It's my money. I can do what I like with it.
Oh, sure. That's your privilege. It's the old routine. Fast horses, fast cars, and now fast planes.
I happen to be interested in aviation.
You're only interested in owning a plane. You don't care whether it's safer, more reliable, or faster. Oh, no. You own a ship, and yet you haven't got what it takes to fly.
Meaning nerve?
Meaning nerve. You know, when I was a kid, there were two kinds of girls. Those that would jump off the barn and those that wouldn't. Personally, I prefer those that would.
And you think I wouldn't?
Why don't we bury the hatchet?
Where, in my neck?
Hey, you forgot your water.
Hiya, gents. Hey, I got that supercharger installed.
Supercharger?
Yes, I've got the usual double supercharger, but I've added an exhaust-driven turbo supercharger. Say, how long is that kitty car going to be parked in here?
Well, I don't know. Until after the races, I guess. I've had a couple of talks with the young lady. She's all right.
Oh, she is.
Say, Polk, did you check the carburetors on my ship?
Yeah, it wasn't the carburetors, it was the magnetos. Say, what kind of mechanics they got out there in Kansas City anyway?
Quiet ones like you.
Yeah. What?
What's wrong with it? Looks all right to me.
Looks like a banana split with marshmallows to me.
Pokey.
Oh, how do you do, Miss Strong?
This is the great Mr. Pokey, who scares everybody half to death with his daily parachute jump.
Oh, now, Miss Strong, my real name is Henry Wadsworth Schultz.
Mr. Schultz, someday you will wait too long before you pull that cord, my friend.
Dick. This is Dick Bennett.
We met last night.
Well, this is Bill.
Yes, sir, we've also met.
Excuse me, I will look at the plane.
You must have learned your heel clicking in Peoria.
Oh, no. I picked that up when I was presented at court.
Court? Who bailed you out?
Ha! One for the lady.
Bill, this is assuming the proportions of a Kentucky feud.
Yeah, cut it out, will you, Bill? Hand me that wrench. Oui, monsieur. Avec plaisir.
Glad to have seen you again, Mr. Bennett.
Thanks.
Is that a nice way to talk to a lady?
Ah, forget it and get back to work.
No, sir, not me. This is my hour off for my music lesson. I'm going up in the clouds in my little umbrella where the atmosphere is not so sizzling. Why don't you try one of these jumps? It might jar some of that sarcasm out of you. Your marksmanship's bad, too.
There's old Oyster McCoyster now. That son of a gun's had everybody scared to death for the last couple of weeks.
Yeah. Ought to make a swell feature for the Sunday edition.
Yeah. That screwball gets a kick out of taking your liver and shoving it right up in your throat when you're watching him. He's supposed to dump over a bag of flour as he falls, so I can keep on snapping him on the way down before he pulls the cord.
Same old maniac.
One of these days they're gonna dig him out of the ground. Better make him cut it out after the meet. Still good a mechanic to be doing that sort of thing.
My daily supply of goose flesh. I never miss seeing the little boy jump off the barn.
Yes, it does take a little intestinal fortitude to dive off the wing of a plane at 15,000 feet, doesn't it?
Yes, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
There he goes.
Oh, look at that guy sail.
Come on, Pokey. Open up, you crazy fool.
Not 600 feet between him and the ground when he pulled that string. I'm a wreck.
Well, he can have all he wants of it.
What's the matter with Pokey? Trying to commit suicide?
4 seconds more and we'd have to pick him up with a sponge.
I love to watch him. But it's unfair to organize spectators.
Say, I'm Morgan of the Daily Review.
Review? Oh, I'm Henry Wadsworth Schultz.
Will you drape that chute around your neck, Pokey?
Oh. How long have you been making these jumps?
Oh, well, when I was a little boy,
Yeah, we know. You fell on your head.
Why'd you take up parachute jumping?
Oh, well, I've always wanted to be
a parachute. Just a little bit. There you are.
How'd you feel after your first jump?
Oh, it's...
You kind of hold your head at this angle. There, just like that. There you are.
Hold your horses.
Gail, or Miss Strong. Well, gee, I'm sorry. Gosh, I didn't know it was you.
Hello, folks.
Hello. Hello. Bill isn't here.
No, I know. I came to see you.
You did?
Uh-huh.
Well, can I offer you anything?
Got any more of that?
Well, sure, sure. Do you want some?
Why not?
I don't know.
Here you are.
Thank you.
That's Bill.
Yes, I know.
Great guy. You know, Bill's daffy about you.
He has a funny way of showing it.
Oh, that's just his way. If he didn't like you, he'd be nice as pie to you.
Well, that's an original idea anyway. How's the plane, Pokey?
Oh, the plane. Gee, it's swell. It's a Lulu.
Uh-huh. Where's the money coming from?
Well, you know, Bill and Dick got every cent they own in the world in that plane, and I have, too. I cashed my last Liberty bond the other day. You know, Bill's got at least a half a dozen of his own gadgets on that plane, and they're going to revolutionize airplane building if they work out.
If they work out.
Everything Bill's got, he's had to fight for. He's had to scrimp and save and fight and bully and bluff to get that airplane together.
I think I'm beginning to understand him a little. I love you, Bill. Well, who's that?
Well, that's Bill's sister.
Oh, isn't she pretty? Have you any pictures of yourself, Pokey?
Oh, sure. Millions of them. Here.
Oh, gee. Excuse me. I'm sorry about the chaise lounge. You see, that's where I sleep when Dick's here.
Now, don't mind me. Come on, let's see the pictures.
Yeah, sure. Here you are.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, that's me right when I landed in the middle of a herd of wild bulls.
What for?
Well, it just seemed to be the thing to do at the time.
Well, here's a parachute on water. Where are you?
I'm 6 feet under the parachute. How in the world did that get in there?
Oh, it takes a lot of fortitude to jump, doesn't it, Pokey?
Huh?
Courage.
Oh, no. No, nothing to it. You see, all you do is just bail out and count 10 and then grab the ring. The ring's right over your heart.
My heart would be up in my throat.
Yeah, well, then you'd probably grab your throat and choke yourself to death. You know, I thought of that right out of my head.
You're wonderful.
Oh, look. Here. Simple.
You know, seriously, Pokey, that's why I came up here. Can I do that?
Well, why do you want to do it?
Oh, I have a reason.
Well, there's no dough in it. I mean, you can't make any money.
I don't want to make money. I want to make one jump, that's all. Just one jump.
So, I think if I can get it for $40, we'll have something, but...
Well, hello. This is a surprise.
Yes, fancy seeing me here.
Yes, fancy.
Did you come over to see how the poor folks live?
Oh, not exactly. I came over to see Pokey and some of his parachute jumps. He spent most of the time talking about the great you and your ship.
Did he show you the plans for our ship?
What was that?
Or maybe you're interested in taking away my best mechanic.
Well, I guess that's my cue for a takeoff. Nice to have seen you again. Goodbye, Pokey.
You ought to be poked in the nose. What do you mean accusing her of trying to steal the plans to the ship and take me away from you? Figure it out for yourself. What's it all about?
Just the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
I'm afraid you're right.
Simple, huh?
See, that's it's an art.
Well, of course it's an art. Now, I'll give it to you in one easy lesson. Here, hold this. There. Now, the only thing a parachute jumper worries about is how he's going to hit.
Yeah, so is everybody watching him.
Well, sure, that's the idea.
Now, hold everything. You're getting me dizzy.
Yeah, me too. Now, there are lots of pleasant possibilities, like twisting an ankle on a loose stone, and then you got to dodge trees and buildings and high-tension wires.
Yeah, well, suppose your chute doesn't open.
Well, then you got nothing else to worry about. Oh, wait a minute. That's the only thing a parachute jumper doesn't worry about. Here it is. First you jump. You count 10. You pull the ring on your left chest. And then you wait until you're close enough to the ground, and you begin to maneuver your shroud ropes.
Oh, nice work.
Yeah, just like I showed you. First on one side and then on the other until you hit the spot you're aiming at. Say, it's the simplest thing in the world. I have sailed from one side of the field to the other while I was dropping.
Well, listen, how do you figure how long to wait in your delayed opening jump?
Oh, well... Hey, don't you try anything like that when you're up there.
Oh, don't worry, I won't.
Now, look, I've got it figured out like this on paper. A body falls at the rate of 120 miles an hour, which is 1,000 feet every 8 seconds. All I do when I jump is just start counting until I figure I'm far enough down, and then I pull the cord. Simplest thing in the world. Here, I'll give it to you in a nutshell. Now, look. Zing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There you are. You got it?
I got it.
Hey, Bill, you gonna take off?
Yeah. Better go over to the factory and get a new brake pedal.
Oh, well, I think she's all right, but you better get a little altitude before you start out.
Okay, Pokey.
Silly?
Wait till you see what happened. Bill said she didn't have any intestinal fortitude. She's going to do a parachute jump.
What is Samuel is Bill trying to do? Look at that.
Why, that crazy fool. That girl's going to get hurt.
If she does, it's your fault.
Did you see his face? Was he worried?
He doesn't like her much. Boy, the war is on.
And how? Oh, that ain't no way to make a spot landing.
I think I'm terrific.
You little brat, you. You're the most asinine person I've ever met.
Oh, I bet you say that to all the girls.
Bailing out of a plane without even knowing how to do it.
Well, at least I didn't light in a ditch.
Oh, you could have broken your neck.
So could the little girl that jumped off the barn. Well, aren't you going to help me down?
You got in this. Suppose you get out of it.
Hey, mister. Give me a puff.
Come on, get out of that tree, you young Tarzan, you. Come
on. Well, now, no. None of your tricks.
Come on.
Oh, you're so good to me.
Do you know what you're doing?
I hope so. And very nice, too. A lot better than kissing hands.
So, first you tried to kill my fiancée, and now you're kissing her.
Your fiancée? Nice work. I understand she's worth 20 million bucks.
Why didn't you tell him how it happened? The night I said yes, there was moonlight. And champagne.
Do you regret it, darling?
I said I'd marry you if you win the race.
Well, have you any doubt I will do it?
Plenty.
So, you think I won't win that race, huh?
And a good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are at the Stanley Cup races. And what races they are. The sun is shining, the clouds are riding high, but not too high for those fearless boys in the air. And there they go, the Hollywood trio, executing a triple.
He is. Look what happened to him.
Well, search me. He left the house an hour ago.
He wouldn't do a thing like this.
Wait a minute. I'll telephone, see if we missed it.
Okay.
Let me talk to the field. He's not there? No message? Thanks. No sign of him. You go on. If he shows up, I'll bring him over in the car.
Please.
This strong American heiress has become well known in aviation circles. Here comes another entry in the Stanley Cup race. The Edwards Meteor, which will be flown by Dick Bennett, famous transport pilot of Consolidated Airlines. Bill Edwards, designer...
Where's the pilot, Mr. Edwards? I don't know.
...stepping onto the cockpit. The ensuing race will be watched with interest by government officials, heads of aviation companies, soldiers, sailors, sweethearts...
I can't find Dick Bennett. Will you hold up the race?
Not a chance.
It's Bill.
Only 15 minutes. I know he'll be here by then.
I'm sorry. We have to run this meet on schedule. If you want to enter your plane in the race, you'll have to leave right on the dot.
All right, I'll fly it myself.
You have a dual permit.
Well, that's funny. I wonder if anything's wrong.
Bill! Bill!
Well, what the... Dick, what happened?
The Baron slugged me.
Well, what for?
I don't know. He must have been doing something to the plane.
Well, Bill's gonna fly that plane. We gotta stop him. Could you make it?
Sure, I'm okay. Let's go.
Attention, please. If Dick Bennett is in the stands, will he kindly come to the judge's box at once? Attention, please. Attention, please. There is a change of pilots on plane number 5 at the starting line.
Dick Bennett, Mr. Edwards? I don't want to
speak to you. Which instead will have Bill Edwards, designer and builder at the controls himself. He's climbing into the cockpit. In just a minute, he will be away.
Bill's going to fly his own plane.
Bill's not a racing pilot. I wonder what happened to Dick.
There goes Bill Edwards.
Bennett?
I want to enter a protest against Baron Haggard.
Why?
What happened? Haggard knocked Dick out.
Oh, Paul.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. I found Dick in the hangar.
My eyes and ears tell me that these boys are smashing all existing speed records. Racing history is being made today. Uh-oh. It's going to seem awfully tame.
Yes, Miss Strong.
Edwards is dead.
Thank you.
Everything that's humanly possible is being done, Dick. You know that.
But he's been unconscious for 4 days.
Here's the nurse.
Nurse, what does the doctor say?
Oh, the doctor will be out in just a moment.
Well, this is all my fault.
No, it isn't, Miss Gale. Honest, it isn't. You couldn't help it.
Yes, I could. I brought Haggard to America.
Haggard will get his.
That doesn't help Bill much.
If I could only see Bill, if I could only talk to him. There's so much he doesn't understand. Doctor, how is he?
He can't live over 48 hours.
Oh, there must be someone somewhere who can help him.
If he were in England, there might be a chance.
What do you mean?
Dr. Crowder of London has just perfected a serum for cases like this.
You say he'll live 48 hours?
I would say so.
Jack, I want your plane.
What are you going to do with it?
I'm going after that serum.
All right, you can have it, but I'm going with you.
Dick, to London and back, it's impossible.
You love that fellow in there, don't you? So do we.
Come on, Jack, let's go.
How much you putting on?
All she'll take.
How much gas have we got?
All she'll take, Dick. They're filling it up. 1,300 gallons.
So long, Porky. See you day after tomorrow.
So long, Dick.
Back a pound of tea, will you?
Okay.
Fellas. Happy landing.
Boy, she sure is a honey.
Certainly is a lot different from the old days, isn't it, Dick? When ships used to be made of cheesecloth, baling wire, fishing poles. I wouldn't taxi one of those crates on the ground on a bet today with a parachute on it.
All eyes are centered upon the flight of Dick Bennett, crack pilot for the Consolidated Airlines, who planed out this morning for London in a desperate effort to save the life of Bill Edwards. Before taking off, Bennett said he would be back in less than 48 hours. This will be the first flight of its kind ever before attended. Good luck, Dick Bennett, and speedy return.
I figure we're about halfway over, Dick. We've been out 10 hours now.
That's just about right.
We have just picked up by shortwave the information that Dick Bennett has been sighted at the coastline in the south of England. He cut inland for Croydon, where he undoubtedly will land in a very few minutes. We will announce his arrival from the station just as soon as the news is flashed to us.
Hello,
Mr. Bennett, allow me to congratulate you.
Thank you, Sir Charles.
Here is the serum. I talked with Dr. Harvey, who transatlantic phone this morning. He understands the treatment perfectly.
You don't know what this means to us, Doctor.
My contribution is very small compared with yours.
A new record in transatlantic flying was established today when Dick Bennett landed at Croydon Airport, England.
They made it! They made it! They made it! They're there! They're in London! They're in England! Hey! Hey, they made it! I knew they would, you old flying fool!
Tanks are filled, sir.
Good. Here's a weather report, sir. There's a terrific storm over the Atlantic, and the Air Ministry advises you wait.
We can't wait. Thank you just the same, though.
Man, you'll never do it.
That's what they told us when we left America. Goodbye, Doctor.
Goodbye, Bennett, and the best of luck.
Thank you.
Goodbye, sir. Glad to meet you.
News of the transatlantic flyers. Dick Bennett and George Carter, who landed at Croydon after a 21-hour flight across the Atlantic, took off almost immediately, waiting just long enough to pick up the serum and refuel their plane. The takeoff was made despite warnings from the British Air Ministry of dangerous storms now raging over the Atlantic.
Look, the oil tank is fine.
It's all right.
Okay, just... News bulletin. There's been no further word from Bennett and Carter.
Dick, we're not making the time that we did on the trip over.
Crash! No word has been heard from Dick Bennett and Jack Carter, who are battling the elements in a desperate effort to fly back from London in time to save the life of Bill Edwards.
Using an awful lot of gas, Dick. Getting kind of low.
Maybe we better throttle back a little.
Did you hear that?
What?
News broadcast just says we're lost.
Maybe they're right. How long have we been out? 18 hours?
All right. Got some hot music here. That put the radio set out of whack.
Oh, gone off of that Porky's tea.
Flash, we have just learned that Washington has ordered Coast Guard cutters to render every possible service in establishing contact with Dick Bennett, who is piloting his plane through terrific storms across the Atlantic Ocean. Several Coast Guard cutters steamed out of Boston Bay this morning in a valiant effort to contact the plane.
You are listening to 2GC Australia, bringing you the latest news of the day. Ici Paris Tour Eiffel.
KJZ.
Due to heavy storms at sea, all efforts to communicate with Dick Bennett have been blocked.
To go from Croydon, England, off a record-breaking flight.
Voici la dernière nouvelle de Bennett et Carter.
But you know, on your home, Kobe, what's all good to go there, miss?
No word has been received from Dick Bennett and Jack Carter.
America's Coulter, Bennett, or maybe Carter.
Amateur wireless operators are requested to stand by for possible contact with the missing plane.
Aviateurs américains partis de Croydon.
Because of the unusual storm area they've encountered.
Ego Croydon Skojo was put stay right.
Angleterre, mon voyage transoceanique.
Great anxiety is restored to the nation's citizens throughout the entire world.
London, please, you won't stay right.
It's autorité, madame, Croydon, the force, don't play on Monday.
Lake you to Bennett.
Give me the morning news.
Lake you to Bennett.
Might as well fold up the tent. Bennett. Those guys are gone now.
Take it easy, will you?
Lake you to Bennett.
Another crack like that out of you and you'll be gone.
Lake you to Bennett. Lake you to Bennett. Lake you to Bennett. Lake you to Bennett. Bennett. Lake you to Bennett. Lake you to Bennett. Lake you to Bennett.
Let me call my paper, Pokey.
Lake you to
There's
Bennett.
No use getting sore about it. Those guys
Lake
are gone.
Bennett.
Aren't they?
Lake you to Bennett.
Can I quote you on that?
Lake you to Bennett. Lake you to
you
Bennett.
You ask for it.
Hello? Yeah? Southfield? All ships give Bennett plane sitting down on Southfield preference. Remain in air and out the field until advised.
Do you hear that? Do you hear that? What did I tell you? Yeah. They're in! They're in! You can print that.
Go away. Give me the Samaritan Hospital. Hello, let me talk to Miss Strong.
Hello. Honey, it's for you.
Hello? Yes, Pokey.
Gail, they're here!
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
Oh, it's them. Get the doctor. Oh, Pokey, I'm so happy.
Happy? Well, what are you crying for? You dame slay me. You always cry when you're happy.
Well, here they come, boys. Hey, listen, fellas, give us a start.
Who gets this?
I'll take it. Thank you.
Oh, come on, be
good. Oh, come on.
Be ready.
Jack.
How's Bill? There's a chance now, a big chance.
It's all right, fella. Everything's gonna be all right.
Name, doctor. Shall I get her?
Yes, just a minute.
He's conscious now and asking for you. Just a moment, dear.
That's all right, old fellow. Just take it easy. You're going to be all right.
Well, what is it, fella? How about it? Internal. You have some news.
Hello.
How's Bill Edwards? Give us a report.
The serum was a success.
Oh, boy, get back here.
Please, quiet.
You said yes, buddy.
Quiet.
Remember, you're in a hospital.
Hey, how about a little service?
Oh, you two goofy throttle benders, you.
You got any coffee for us, Mary?
You bet. Coming right up.
Hey, fellas. Did you read about these two going to fly across the Atlantic Ocean and back? They'll never make it.